join me with a warm welcome to banjoist Jim Coston.
Major programs in the United States, welfare, unemployment, just to name a few. It's a pleasure to be with you here this evening. Now, I lived in New Orleans for many, many years, but I must be honest with you. Originally, I'm from Florida. Any Floridians here? Yeah. Where in Florida are you from?
Newport Richey.
Newport Richey, Pasco County. Yeah. Glad to have you from there. Where else do we have in Florida?
Naples,
down south. I'm not too far from you in Pasco County. I'm from a very small town in central Florida. You probably never ever heard of it. A small town called Resume Speed. Right next to No Dumping, if you know where that's at. Since we have some Floridians here, I'd like to do for you an old Stephen Foster tune. That's because there are no new Stephen Foster tunes. This is the state song of Florida. You know this as Swanee River. But that is not the original title of it. Originally, it was an old Seminole Indian love song entitled, We Made Whoopee in the Teepee, or The Passion Was Intense. Waiter, is my check ready?
Thank you.
you. And now, you know a little bit about me, and I'd like to find out just a little about you. I'd like to do just a little bit of a survey. If we could have some housewives so I can see these wonderful people. Oh, there you are. Let's find out something interesting about you as an audience. Just a show of hands. How many happily married people are here? Raise your hands if you're happily married. Have couples that are looking at each other going, are we happy? I don't know. I said happily, not halfway up there in the balcony. Okay, how many people have been married more than 10 years? More than 10 years of marriage? More than 10, more, now wait a second, we got hands going up that didn't go up on the happy part. More than 20 years? More than 30 years? More than 40 years of marriage? Oh, we have to go for the gold. More than 50 years of marriage? We got a few over there, give a round of applause over there, and right there in the second row. Find out the real truth. How many people feel like you've been married more than 50 years? Raise your hand. Now, wait a second. I do not believe that. My father once told me that a man is not complete until he gets married. And then he's finished. I'd like to do a tune for everybody who's been married more than 20 years, a very appropriate tune entitled, Please Release Me, Let Me Go. That's a joke. So for more than 20 years, there's only one appropriate tune, and here it is. Once in a while. Would you believe it's impossible? No. A tune you can all sing along to. A tune entitled, Let Me Call You Sweetheart, Because I've Called You Everything Else. Here we go. Because I'm not married. Now, I could marry any girl I please. I just haven't pleased any of you. And now I'm at that awkward age. I'm too old to be a gigolo and too young to be a greeter at Walmart. I guess I should explain why I never got married. Every time I met a girl I liked, I'd bring her home to meet my mother. No matter what, my mother would not approve of her. She didn't look right, didn't talk right, didn't act right, didn't dress right, didn't cook right. Nothing was right. Finally, I met a girl that looked like my mother. She talked like my mother, acted like my mother, dressed like my mother, even cooked like my mother. My father couldn't stand her. Now I'm sure many of you are aware that the banjo is considered by many historians to be one of the few original American instruments, and I'm quite proud to say that I've helped make it what it is today. Obsolete. And although it's an American instrument, actually there are many wonderful banjo players all around the world. I've heard great banjo players in Canada, in England, Australia, Japan, even in Jamaica. So I thought throughout this evening's show we should do some international music for you. And since we happen to be on our way to Australia, I thought something Spanish would be appropriate. We'll be right back. 25 years now, and when I began playing the instrument, I did not begin playing on a beautiful cruise ship like this one in front of a wonderful audience like yourself. Like every musician, I began by playing privately in my own bedroom where I would bribe friends and family to come in to listen to me. But after a while, I wanted to play for the public. It's not an easy thing to do when you begin. So I did what every musician does. I volunteered my time and played anywhere they would let me. I remember I used to play at hospitals and at nursing homes. One day I was playing at a hospital. I guess I'd been playing for about an hour. I looked up at this gentleman and I said, "I hope you get better soon." And he looked at me and he said, "I hope you do too." Now, I learned to play banjo by listening to the recordings of the great banjo players of the 1930s and 40s, people like Harry Reisler and Roy Smack and Jad Paul, Michael Pingatori. But my favorite is a fellow by the name of Eddie Peabody. I don't know whether anybody here remembers Eddie Peabody or not. He's a wonderful performer in the 1930s and 40s. This next tune is a trademark tune for him. It's actually written back in 1919 by a gentleman from London, Ontario, Canada. Any Canadians in the room tonight? Yeah. Gentleman wrote the song in 1919, and he was not only a songwriter, he was also an actor, and his wife was an actress, and their daughter was an actress. His name was Jean Lockhart. His wife was Kathleen, and their daughter, June Lockhart. So he wrote the song in 1919, and it became a trademark for Eddie Peabody and a big hit for Les Paul and Mary Ford, who nobody here is old enough to remember. A tune called "The World is Waiting for the Sunrise."
Thank you.
20s tune or a Spanish tune or a riverboat tune, but I gotta tell you, one of my favorite types of music happens to be Broadway show tunes. Do you like Broadway shows? Oh, good. Just yell out your favorite shows so I know what you like.
South Pacific.
South Pacific, anything else?
Chicago.
Oklahoma. Fiddler on the Roof.
Oklahoma.
Oklahoma. Phantom of the Opera? Wow, what a show. And so much banjo music, I wouldn't know where to get. I heard two different people yell out Oklahoma. You like that show? I tell you what, tonight we're going to do for you the entire musical score to Oklahoma. It takes 2.5 hours. Don't plan on making the buffet. No, we're going to do the Reader's Digest condensed version. And for those of you who wanted South Pacific, Chicago, the Vita Music Man, and Phantom of the Opera. This has a lot of the same notes in it as those shows. I know that we have people from all over the world here, not just from the United States. So let me hear the Canadians again. Yeah. Do we have anybody here from the United Kingdom? Yeah. We have a few in the back. Anybody from New Zealand? They must be at the bar. I guess that's everybody. How about, okay, one more, Australia. Yeah. Thought we might have a couple of you here tonight. So I was looking for a song that I could do that you might all know, that not a very common song for an American to do, but there was a performer in Great Britain back in the 1930s and 40s who played a banjo ukulele. His name is George Formby. How many people here remember George Formby? For those of you who are not familiar with him, his career spanned 40 years from 1921 to 1961. In 1939, he was the highest paid entertainer in Great Britain. He played a banjo ukulele. It was a banjo just a little bit shorter than this one here. And he recorded over 300 songs in his career, many of which during their time would have been considered a little bit risque. By today's standards, they're nothing. But they're a lot of fun, and I thought it would be kind of fun to do one for you this evening that George Formby recorded in 1937 about a guy who's got a job that's even better than mine. Oh, you're way ahead of me over here, aren't you? Cleaning windows and all the things he gets to see along the way. Now, one caveat. I'm from Louisiana. I'm totally devoid of a Lancashire accent, so this is going to be kind of a good old boy version of George Formby's window cleaner. I hope you like it. One, for Mardi Gras, and I didn't even know how good a time I had until I read the arrest report. Now, I thought we'd take you down there and do a little bit of Dixieland jazz, a tune we do down on Bourbon Street called Sweet George Brown. We'll be right back. find out if we have any Irish people in the room tonight. We have some Irish people over here. I can do an Irish tune for you. Now, I'm not Irish myself. Actually, I'm half Scotch and half bourbon. But here are a couple Irish tunes, and if you happen to know them, feel free to sing them. When we warm up, we'll do a fast one for you. Do we have any bluegrass fans out here tonight? You like bluegrass? That's a shame because I don't play any. No, I should explain. You see, bluegrass is traditionally played on a five-string banjo. I play what's known as a tenor or a four-string banjo, and unfortunately, bluegrass sounds more like, well, like crabgrass, actually. But there is one tune I can do for you that was featured in a motion picture about 35 years ago that starred Burt Reynolds and John Voight. How many people would like to hear dueling banjos with me? Okay, how many people realize it takes two banjos to play dueling? All right, here it is, dueling banjos from the movie Belligerents. Deliverance. What did you expect? No cover, no minimum. No, we're going to do this for real. I'm going to be ably assisted by our wonderful musical director, James, who will be playing the other half of dueling banjos on the 88-string black upright banjo. For those of you who saw the movie, he's the one who drools. Play page 9. Lovers here tonight. You like classical music? You're gonna hate this. You know, I was very lucky growing up to study the music of all the great classic composers. People like Bach, Beethoven, Gucci, Bridge and Stratton, Black and Decker, just to name a few of my favorites. This is a classical piece that I hope you recognize and enjoy. Not only was it a classical piece, it was also the theme song to a very popular 1930s radio show. The theme to the Lone Ranger, the William Tell Overture. Now, this was originally written for a 120-piece symphony orchestra, but I have decomposed it. It's a derangement I wrote myself. I hope you enjoy it. Here it is, the William Tell Overture, Cha-Cha-Cha. Thank you. time's flown so quickly this evening, I have time just for one last tune. But before I go, if you'll indulge me, I'd like to share with you a backstage show business story because I think it's important. Every evening, you will come into this beautiful lounge and you'll see a different show. And that means that the talented musicians behind me every night have to do a new show. They saw these charts for this show at 5 p.m. this afternoon for the first time. Rehearsed it in less than 1 hour. That is truly remarkable. Please help me thank the house act for such a wonderful job. And they're so cute at that age, aren't they, ladies and gentlemen? And secondly, most important of all, let me thank you. Somebody once told me the most important thing you can give anybody is your time. And I want to thank you for giving me a little bit of your time this evening. Not that you had anywhere else to go, but appreciate you being here anyway. If it weren't for you being here, this would have been another rehearsal. You know, working on cruise ship as an entertainer is a wonderful job. It's different here than working on land, though. And probably the best reason why it's different is when you work on land in a nightclub, at the end of the evening, you go home and your audience goes home. Here's different, ladies and gentlemen, because tomorrow morning, I'm having breakfast with y'all. Yeah, I'm no longer anonymous, you know who I am. You see me out about, don't be shy, I'd love to talk to each and every one of you. Right now, I have just enough time to say, once again, thanks for being such a wonderful audience, and I'll leave you with a tune called Bye Bye Blues. Thank you, good night.
Jim Coston!